Hello guys, and welcome to Joshua Tree. About 2 hours east of Los Angeles in the desert right now. Feels amazing to escape the city for a bit and to come out here. And normally I film these little intros to my videos, you know, outside in the exterior with the property I'm staying at in the background, but it's actually so windy here today. The desert, it's like 20, 25 mile per hour winds right now. You wouldn't be able to hear a single word I'd be saying right now. So right now I'm on the couch in the interior of the tiny house, and I'll get to the layout of everything just in a bit. But this is called the Little Dipper Tiny House in Joshua Tree. Definitely a luxury vibe, a little bit of a modern vibe. It's also very off-grid as well. So I can kind of describe it as a modern luxury off-grid experience here in this tiny house. If you want to check out the Little Dipper though, I'll link it out to its Airbnb listing down in the video description as usual. Also, you want to book this tiny house or any other tree house, A-frame cabin, any other Airbnb anywhere in the world. My Airbnb code is also as well down in the video description, so use that to save money off of your next booking. But now I think it's time to hop into a tour of the Little Dipper Tiny House in Joshua Tree, California. Let's do it. When you first arrive to the tiny house, you're going to pull up in your car to the right of the tiny house, kind of behind it like this, and welcome to the Little Dipper in Joshua Tree. So you're gonna, you know, kind of get all your stuff out of the car and begin to walk over this nice little path right here made of stones and pebbles, and it'll go into this kind of turf area. And this is kind of laid out with all of your outdoor amenities. There's a lot to cover, but for the time being, kind of get a little bit closer to the tiny house to show off some of the design. I will mention super quick that if the tiny house is booked up, the hosts have another property right next to it called the Moon Camp. I really wanted to do a shoot here before it was fully booked up as well, but it's this really cool kind of desert home that reminded me of a scene from Star Wars. Now back to the tiny house. I will mention this actually is a tiny house on wheels. You can see the hookup right here if you want to attach it to like a trailer or your pickup truck. But now we're going to kind of showcase some of the amazing outdoor amenities here at the Little Dipper. So I'll start over here on this end. They have actually two hammocks, which is a really nice setup. It was really kind of dangling in the wind because, you know, it was very windy the day I was there, but this is definitely a nice touch, especially for sunset or for sunrise. They also have this table right here as well. So it's definitely a nice kind of picnic table to have some meals out there to get some work done. They also have a fire pit. I just decided not to turn it on because it was just so windy and I think it was kind of gonna stay on, didn't want to risk it, but it's definitely a nice place to relax and start your morning. Now I'll mention the last amenity to point out outdoors, and that is the grill setup. But next I want to kind of definitely mention the location. So again, we are in Joshua Tree. This is so much land and space out here. And I obviously love the Joshua Trees. This is taken right around sunrise. And you can actually go from this opposite end. There's some kind of trails around, you know, the tiny house, but it's this beautiful area, these mountains in the background. This is kind of now I'm flying my drone in the immediate area. This is one of the roads leading to the tiny house, but it's an absolutely gorgeous area. Great place to escape off-grid for a bit. Now it's finally time to head inside of your tiny house. And welcome to the interior of the Little Dipper. You can probably tell pretty quickly that it's very wide open and spacious for a tiny house. I've seen a ton of tiny houses by now. This one by far uses the space to the best of its ability of any other tiny house. And of course, yes, another movie reference is coming. I couldn't help but think of this scene from the movie Step Brothers.
Look at all this floor space. So much
aerobics in here.
So many activities.
So I had to see how many activities I could do.
Look at all this floor space. So many
aerobics in here.
So many activities.
If you haven't clicked off the video by now or unsubscribed from my channel because all my movie references, let's continue with the tour. We'll first go to this nice living room setup. So you're gonna see a couch in the background and a coffee table. There's a mirror off to one side. There's also some great natural light though streaming in. There's kind of three windows in this area. So beautiful lighting when I was there. And there's two books as well that were left out on the coffee table. This is actually their guest book. So if you flip through that, you can hear from some of the other guests that stayed there before you. Also, if you're a tiny house enthusiast, they also left you behind a tiny house book. So I'd definitely give that a flip through and check it out. This is the view as if you're sitting on the couch looking out into the kitchen area. But to explore some more of this little kind of living room space in that corner, which I haven't covered yet, there's actually a little telescope, which is pretty cool for stargazing because there is really nothing out here. So it's perfect for stargazing. There's also a TV, and then back here is actually a heater that's kind of crammed up here underneath the stairs. You kind of hook that up to some propane. You can use that to heat up the whole tiny house in the colder months. But overall, this is definitely a very nice space. Very spacious as well, I thought, for a tiny house. Next to the living room is actually a really nice table right here. This is obviously great for eating meals, for getting some work done. I'm a digital nomad, so I actually got a ton of work done here right at this table. I'm always working remotely, and especially these days, a lot of people need kind of a good workspace, and this is it. Now we're gonna finally check out the kitchen area, and there's a lot to cover here. Again, not only does this tiny house do an amazing job with this space and how well it utilizes everything, this also, I think, by far the most well-stocked kitchen I've ever had before in a tiny house. So you have kind of a Keurig over here and plenty of coffee options there for all your mugs. You have some wine glasses up top. This sink is very, very large again. And kind of on the left-hand side, you have a toaster and some more utensils and plates. We'll check out some of the drawers real quick. The top drawer has some utensils and the kitchen essentials. The middle drawer has plenty of pots and pans for you to make a full meal. And the bottom drawer kind of has some other extra, you know, miscellaneous kitchen supplies. And right next to that is your fridge. This is a pretty, you know, full-fledged fridge. You know, you have a refrigerator obviously in the bottom with plenty of space, and up top you have your freezer. And directly opposite of that is the stove area. It also has another kind of countertop space, which is nice. And I guess I'm trying to really kind of demonstrate here with this like kind of photo frame, just actually the house rules, is how small, just to kind of give you some perspective, some framing, but how thin and how small this stove is. It's kind of very squished over there, but I thought it was kind of funny how small the stove was. Again, making great use of the space. Those were the house rules as well, which is out and about, nice to kind of be seen. You have kind of some other kind of oils and cooking supplies up here on the shelf. But now let's go and check out the bathroom. So there is a sliding door, obviously for privacy reasons, is the only kind of walled off space in the tiny house. But welcome to the bathroom, and this is pretty much it. Again, obviously the tiny house, so it's not, you know, super big, but you have your toilet and all the basic necessities, and you have a sink and, you know, your shower off on the right hand side with the kind of nice white subway tile. So yeah, I was a fan of this bathroom. It was clean, it was white, it was modern. That pretty much covers it for the entire ground floor of the tiny house. And real quick though, I'd really appreciate your support. If you're enjoying this video, please give it a like, give it a thumbs up. Also subscribe for weekly videos just like this to the most unique Airbnbs and accommodations. We'll now begin to head up the stairs. There's actually great storage options as well underneath the stairs. Plenty of little cubbies and drawers and just options to store your luggage or any other valuables. We'll now head up the stairs to the final room I haven't covered yet in the tiny house, and that is the loft. So we're gonna head on up, and it was pretty easy. I had no issues. And welcome to the loft space in the Little Dipper tiny house. So obviously the bed takes up the majority of the space here in the loft. I've stayed in a bunch of lofts before, like they don't have, you know, easy outlets or, you know, enough space. But this is me kind of laying down in the bed. And again, I'm just under 6 feet. I had no issues. And it's a little bit close to your head, but as long as you don't, you know, wake up abruptly, you're fine. So I thought it was spacious enough for me. They actually do have outlets on both sides of the bed, which is very helpful to charge your electronics. And this is kind of the view, you know, sitting down the bed. So you're gonna have some great natural light streaming in from these two large windows, both on the left and the right hand side. I hope you guys enjoyed the tour of this really cool modern luxury off-grid tiny house in Joshua Tree, California. If you did, please help me out. Give this video a like, give it a thumbs up. Helps to be shown to more people here on the platform on YouTube. Also, share this with a family member or a friend via Facebook, Reddit, email, Instagram, whatever it may be, and say, hey, check out this really cool tiny house in Joshua Tree in the desert. I think we should, you know, escape the city for a bit and go ahead and check it out. Also, if you're watching this and you're still not subscribed, please consider hitting that subscribe button, guys. I'm pouring so much of my time time and effort and financial resources into just making this my full-time thing, you know, as soon as possible. I really, really enjoy making these videos. I want to make it my full-time job as soon as possible, and I can't do that without your support. So please hit that subscribe button. It would seriously mean the world to me. I've come out with weekly videos just like this, if it's the best Airbnbs, hotels, unique accommodations all over the world. And I have tons of more shoots planned out for the rest of the year. So please hit that subscribe button. I'd sincerely appreciate it. Also, send a link out to my playlist somewhere up here. It's my favorite unique Airbnbs I've shot so far on the channel. So be sure to check that out. I've shot just so many other tiny houses and tree houses and A-frame cabins. I'm sure if you enjoyed this video, you can find plenty of other videos you might love to check out here on my channel. So thanks so much for the support, guys. I really appreciate it. And I'll see you in the next episode.